12, it is first divided into two types. Number one, simple sugar, another one is complex sugar. This simple sugar is further divided into the different types. Now, this is triose. This is three carbon compounds. Triose, tetrose, four carbon compounds, pentose, five carbon compounds, and hexose, six carbon compounds. And the examples of the triose sugar is dihydroxy, acetone, or trigonometrihydrate. And the tetrose is the example, tetrose, and the pentose sugar is ribose, which is found in the main precursor of the nucleic acid, either RNA or DNA. Hexose is glucose and fructose. Glucose is plus sugar. Now, this complex sugar is subdivided into two types, one is oligosaccharide and another one is polysaccharide. This oligosaccharide is subdivided into the disaccharide and trisaccharide. Sucrose and lactose, maltose are the examples for trisaccharide. Sucrose is a table sugar and lactose is a milk sugar. Here is the polysaccharide. Whenever it is more than 9 glucose units combined with each other, they form a polymer, and such type of the polymers are categorized as polysaccharides. These polysaccharides are further subdivided into homopolysaccharides and heteropolysaccharides. Whenever the same compounds form a polymer, then that subset of polysaccharide is known as homopolysaccharide. Example is glycogen, starch, and chitin. Chitin is the exoskeleton of the insect. Exoskeleton of insect, you have remembered cockroach, housefly, lizard, their exoskeleton is made up of chitin. Here is the heteropolysaccharide. Whenever more than two polymers are some different types of the units of monosaccharide combined with each other, they form a polysaccharide. Such type of polysaccharides are categorized as heteropolysaccharide. Example, epirin. Epirin is an anticoagulant which is found in your blood. So, we will come to the next part, the chirotarsal. Have you any problem? Okay.
What is isomer?
Whenever the molecular formula is same, but structure formula then we talk about the September to our blue coach. Then we go to the blue coach. Blue coach is hydrosolar. Blue coach is hydrosolar. Why is hydrosolar? Because the aldehyde will be present. 10 portion so generates the spectrum because this the carbon of 5th and carbon of 1st so generating light spectrum and that ring light spectrum reminds me either alpha or beta in that way. This is the carbon number 5. This is the carbon number 5. Carbon number 5. Now friends, here is it. There are two rows of electrons present in this oxygen. This oxygen has been two rows of electrons. And this hydroxyl group of carbon number 5. Hydroxyl group of the carbon number 5. This hydroxyl group forms on say hydroxyl group. Whenever it forms a hydroxyl group, either in far or near, whenever this hydroxyl group is near to this O, when this hydroxyl group, when this hydroxyl group is near to this O, then it becomes beta forms. When this hydroxyl group is here, then it forms alpha. When it is far from this O, it forms alpha anomer. When it is near this O, it forms beta anomer. Now you see here, in this way, there are two conditions. One is the beta forms, another one is the alpha forms. This is the alpha anomer. This is alpha anomer. And next is in beta anomer. In the same way as alpha electro, you run out thing also, maybe case of this furan. The furan rings is shown by the hexose, bromocyanate, in case of galactose and hydroxyl group is coming to the side in the left side, but glucose is in the right side. So therefore, at carbon number 4 shows the mirror image. Carbon number 4 of the glucose shows the mirror image in galactose. Therefore, the galactose and glucose are considered as epimers. Glucose and galactose are considered as epimers. And they form a beta 1,4 glyceride bond in case of lactose. Lactose is commonly known as milk sugar. Because it is found in milk, so therefore it is known as milk sugar. In the same way, the sucrose. Sucrose is commonly known as table sugar. It is non-reducing because both ends are fine to the rotated water reactions. And the sucrose is made up of glucose and glucose. Tetrarotatory glucose with tetrarotatory glucose. The cellulose is also a diatomite, and that is mostly in case of cotton, jute, paper. And it is made up of by the beta 1,4 glyceride bond of glycopyranose. Now students, if you talk about the polysaccharide, these are the polymers of monosaccharide. So question is, what is polysaccharide? These are the monomers of monosaccharide. That monosaccharide is in the form of glucose. These are energy supporting molecules. Polysaccharides are mostly known as energy supporting molecules. So then these polysaccharides are further subdivided into two types. One is homopolysaccharide, another one is heteropolysaccharide. Whenever the same monosaccharide unit forms a polymer, then it is known as homopolysaccharide. Such as chitin. Chitin is made up of N-acetyl-glucosamine. And chitin is mainly found in the exoskeleton of insects. And the second one is glycogen. Glycogen is found in the liver. And it is a reserve food of animals. And now today, in case of glycogen, there are two types of glyceride bonds are present, alpha-1,4 and alpha-1,6. Starch is also a energy storing molecule in plants, and it is made up of amylose and amylopectin with the alpha-1,4 and alpha-1,6 linkage. Cellulose, in case of cellulose, the glycosidic bond is beta-1,4 and the plant ligands to the cellulose. Why? Right? Their beta-glycosidic bond is the